We all know Usain Bolt for his absolute supremacy over the 100 and the 200 meters. For close to 10 straight years, he was far and away the most untouchable athlete in track and field. And honestly, he just might have been the most dominant athlete in the world. When you think about Bolt, you think of this. A larger-than-life sprinter with more confidence than pretty much anyone, and although he certainly believed in himself, he wasn't the stone-cold, braggadocious athlete we've seen previously. He was different. He was a relaxed and easygoing runner who would quite often even make jokes directly into the camera. Frequently, we'd see him dancing just moments before his races started. He would even interact with many of the younger workers on the track just moments before he started his races. Man, it's hard not to smile when you see that. I remember watching Bolt during his prime, and I think it's safe to say that he was literally unbeatable when he was at his absolute best. In almost every race, he was so fast that he could easily cruise through the finish line with a huge smile on his face. But he wasn't always considered the greatest sprinter of all time. Throughout his career, we've seen countless world championship titles, multiple Olympic victories, and a ridiculous amount of world record moments. But when did Bolt truly become the greatest sprinter in the history of the sport? What single moment brought him eternal success that solidified him as the undisputed GOAT? This is the story of Usain Bolt's most immortal track and field moment. To better understand how Bolt became the one true GOAT of sprinting, we have to go all the way back to 2002. At just 15 years old, the young Jamaican was already showing tremendous promise on the world's highest stage. And although he wasn't even old enough to legally drive, he was already running unreal times. He was even running faster than athletes 4 or 5 years older than him. In the 2002 World Junior Championships, he experienced his first international win. In the 200 meter final, Bolt placed first with a time of 20.61 seconds. This victory made him the youngest World Junior gold medalist ever, and although he stated that he had never been more nervous before a race, he came through in the clutch, and this single moment would forever shape the remainder of his track and field career. At 6'5", Bolt was already a towering and dominant athlete, but even he had no idea that he would one day become one of the most decorated athletes in track and field history. Now, you might be thinking, Bolt became the GOAT back in 2009, where he broke the 100 and the 200 meter world records. These performances were absolutely earth-shattering, but this did not make him the GOAT. You also might be thinking about the 2008 Olympic Games, when Bolt exploded onto the world scene by winning the 100 meter dash in world record time. In the same Olympics, Bolt also broke the 200 meter world record with an amazing time of 19.30 seconds. Again, this was truly an Olympic moment to remember, but this was not his GOAT moment. Over the course of his career, we've seen this man do things that have completely shattered all sprinting expectations. But if you're wanting to watch the race that made Usain Bolt the one true GOAT, we need to go back to 2015. Coming into this season, Bolt was still recovering from an unfortunate injury that he sustained in March of 2014. After this injury, Bolt missed a full 9 weeks of training, leaving him completely out of shape and struggling for the remainder of his 2014 campaign. Unlike the previous years of endless racing domination, he only ran 5 races before the World Championships in 2015, and his performances? Well, they were not good. In fact, going into the championships, Bolt's season only put him as the 20th fastest sprinter in the world for that year. This was unheard of. This clearly was not the same Usain Bolt that the world had known previously. This was someone different. This was clearly a struggling athlete, and many people had doubts about his ability to bring home the gold medal once again. And while there were many great athletes in 2015, one athlete in particular was aiming to bring down the great Jamaican sprinter, and that athlete was Justin Gatlin from the United States. Now, Gatlin himself was no stranger to the spotlight. In 2004, he won the Olympic gold medal in the 100 meters, and during the same Olympics, he also won the bronze medal in the 200. The following year in 2005, He won both the 100 and the 200 meters in the World Championships, running 9.88 for the 100 and a 20.04 for the 200. But then 2006 happened. This was the year where Gatlin tested positive for testosterone, and although he denied knowledge of any illegal drug use, he was officially banned from competition for 4 years. During this 4-year stretch, Gatlin saw Bolt destroying both the 100 and the 200 meters. During this time, Bolt set a total of 5 world records, 3 of which still stand today. After returning to the track in 2010, Gatlin began improving little by little every year. In 2012, Gatlin regained his Olympic form with a 3rd-place finish in the 100-meter final. For this performance, Gatlin ran a solid time of 9.79 seconds. Moving into 2014, he continued showing great promise as he won both the 100 and the 200 meters during that year's Diamond League Finals. Against all odds, Gatlin was the proud owner of the fastest times in the world for both events that year, running a 9.77 for the 100 and a 19.68 for the 200 meters. Boosted by his newfound self-confidence and world-leading times, Gatlin entered the 2015 season with a heavy prediction against his Jamaican rival.
Are you going to win?
Justin, we need to hear you say.
We need to guarantee.
I'm bringing the gold medal back to the U.S. of A.
Yes. He just said he's going to win.
I'm going to win.
Now, I get that Gatlin was excited in this clip, but come on. You're going to predict a gold medal against an athlete that hasn't lost a world championship or Olympic race since 2007. Well, good luck with that. But for real, the heat was on throughout the entire 2015 season, and Bolt was clearly not in his typical form. Generally, Bolt could walk a 100-meter dash in well under 10 seconds, but this year, breaking the 10-second barrier was a huge obstacle. And as the season progressed and Bolt continued to struggle, many saw this season as the potential end to Bolt's reign as the greatest sprinter in the world. After an incredibly challenging season building up to the World Championships, Gatlin was widely accepted as the better sprinter for the entire season. In comparison to Bolt's seasonal bests, Gatlin had run a 9.74 second 100 meters, and he had also run a 19.57 for the 200. To put it simply, Gatlin was simply running better than Bolt, and as the day finally arrived where Bolt faced off against Gatlin, the entire track and field world was holding its breath. For the previous 7 years, Bolt was literally invincible during championship races. No matter how hard anyone else tried, Bolt always found a way to win. But this was a rare moment for Bolt. It truly seemed as though he was in trouble, and many thought that Gatlin was finally going to take down the Jamaican sprinter. But here's the thing about Bolt. He is the GOAT. He's the one athlete that will always show up when it matters most. And on August 23rd, 2015, he ran what just might be the single most clutch 100-meter race in the history of track and field.
Bolt gets out pretty well, so does Rogers. Gatlin's got out a little bit better though, and Bolt and Gatlin are right together here. It's Gatlin at the moment, and here comes Usain Bolt, and Bolt gets it! Oh, does he? I think he has! Usain Bolt!
Just imagine being Justin Gatlin in this moment. You've already talked trash for the majority of the season, and even though you've run much faster than him for the previous 3 months, Bolt showed up and ran one of the most clutch 100-meter sprints in track and field history. This wasn't just a victory. This was a struggling athlete who had just defeated the absolute best sprinters in the entire world. With a finishing time of 9.79 seconds, Bolt showed the world that he was the man once again. But we haven't even talked about the 200-meter final. In Bolt's own words, he said, "I'm not losing the 200. That's my event." And I'm gonna let you guess what happened in the finals. Unlike the 100, Bolt won this race easily. With a finishing time of 19.55 seconds, Bolt had just run the 10th fastest time in history, despite a very subpar season beforehand. In an interview with Gatlin after the 200-meter final, he said that everyone has a responsibility, and my responsibility was to make that dude run fast. There are literally hundreds of races to choose from when discussing Bolt's greatest moments, But no other race during his career had an impact like this one. This race was a confirmation. It now proved a fact, not just an opinion. Usain Bolt is unquestionably the greatest sprinter of all time.